Roman. I mean, yeah, they probably have her doing it big because no one cares about this show. Age 11. Roman Cassidy. That must be her dub name, right? Kirishima Roman is a character from Yu-Gi-Oh! 7. She's Yuga's classmate and a talented student and sportswoman who is a guitarist, who is the guitarist of Roa Roman. Oh, Roa, one of the, that's another character. I think that's her cousin or something. Let's see. What's her record, though? This would not be the thumbnail for the Roman Cutie Pie video chat. All right, what's her record? Oh, she's in character chat. She duelled against the boy and lost. Okay, one, two, three. So she's 3-2, 4-2, 5-2, 5-3. And 6-3 is not bad. Six and three. He gave me the. Where was it? I'm sorry. No, he didn't give me the win loss record. That's pretty good. Roman is honestly doing better, apparently. Perhaps lesson learned. Only took 20 years, by the way. We're not going to talk about air representation with Merrick. I mean, that's. I mean, you can make an argument. Yu-Gi-Oh! The original DM has a lot of air representation. Because, I mean, a lot. They do go to Europe, Egypt. So, you know. I would like to see more black characters in Yu-Gi-Oh! Chat, but it be what it be. She actually beats Yuga later on. 6-3 is great. Oh, you guys are right. She loses to him at first, but then she beats him in episode 40. Which is also not traditional, chat. Usually the girl doesn't duel the protagonist this deep into the, what's it called? Like, yeah, usually the girl doesn't duel the protagonist this deep into the show. I'm trying, usually they'll duel very early on, but then after that, like, it's not gonna happen. He gave you an outdated record. Oh. Roman Cassidy. The beauty Roman. She is 11, by the way, chat, before you guys start looting her. She's freaking 11. Roman as she's already little. Why does she need to get little her? What? You know, what? Taya beat the penguin guy, and she also beat Mai. I don't care if Mai quit. That's still a win. If your opponent quits, you still win. Roman summons Prima Gitarna during her rush duel with Yuya. This is probably like episode 40. She refuses to sing because she's mad. Roman catches Mimi stealing Yuga's notebook. They're just so little, chat. Maybe it's because I'm old. They're just so little. Roman is coerced by her cousin. I guess it's that type of family. I didn't know this show took place in Alabama. Alright. Dude, why is it so long? Rye, how long is this? Jesus Christ. It's like this girl's entire life. She's 11. Why is her wiki this long? She can't have that much life experience. She's 11. I think it's the same exact win-loss record, chat. What changed? I think the last one was 71. Oh, okay, this is the other little girl, I guess. Anyways, there you go, chat. Now you guys know all about Little Roman. Because Yu-Gi-Oh! Wiki is said. Oh, this is actually a song? I thought this was just a gotcha meme. Wait, what? That's a grown adult? Where? Hold on. This is an adult? No. This is like a little girl. She's 37. Why does she look like she's 8? And why did she lose to an 11-year-old? What? If an 11-year-old beat... Oh my god, she's actually... She's older than me. Mimi is 37 years old, but she has the appearance of a preteen. The eternal elementary school student. Oh, this is that character! Chat. There was this thing on Reddit, and it was, I guess it's her. She's like in disguise, and she says, by day I'm something something, but by night I'm a mom. And I was like, what the hell? I guess this is the character. I don't know, chat. I mean, I get that she's my age, but I don't know if I could get down with that. I don't know if I could get down with that, chat. Cause yeah, she looks like a little girl. Why is she blushing? She's like almost 40. And this kid's like 10. Anyways. Look up her son. Where's her son? She plays Bubble Era. That's kinda cool. Her son is 10. There you guys go, chat. And her son plays a naked wrestling man deck. Not got you, by the way. She's a cougar who just looks like a baby cat. I don't know. Well, Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s is interesting. Drytron versus Infernoble. Okay, maybe I'm thinking of somebody else. Come on, Drytron, keep winning. Prove to everyone that Protoss didn't kill your deck. That wrestler is him. This is a 10-year-old kid? Oh, he's wearing a suit. Oh, okay. I'm like, that's a 10-year-old kid? Doesn't look like the same person. Look at all those PK cards. Speaking of such, has there been any Yu-Gi-Oh card? Well, Konami doesn't usually come out with cards on Saturday. What card is this, chat? I'm just curious because I want to know. Does anyone know? The new oh yeah, I didn't read them. I mean, I guess. It's a Rush Duel card. It's a Rush Duel trap. I wanted to know for science. I wanted to know for science, yes. It has a... What is she, a fox girl or something? You know what's interesting? If you just took these weird ears off, she'd just be a regular girl. So, who was the person who was like, I'm just gonna put like dog ears or fox ears on humans? Like, what Japanese guy was the one who thought of that, Jack? Because she looked like a regular girl if she didn't have those weird ears. I don't know. It's a little bizarre. No, I've never, what's it called, chat? I haven't looked at the, I looked at the new heroic cards. Was kind of unimpressed, honestly. And I saw that they were releasing Symphonic.
Oh, have you forgotten that the amazing power of money can do anything?
It made me think that this set might be unsavable.
Makes life happy!
Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s actually treat its female characters much better. Dylan did make a video on it. Can we support him by watching this video too? Don't worry, I skipped the part that we covered.
Peace, Dad. You guys listen to Dylan and I'll... What's it called? I'll discuss more.
Who is actually the main threat of one of the arcs, which, if you can think of girl characters that have been main threats of arcs, the list is very, very short. Asana's entire motivation was based on wanting revenge for her grandfather because of what Gohan Corporation did to her and her family's legacy by not producing machines anymore. She was the president of the Machine Cavalry Club, which is what her family's invention was, creating these machines where you could duel and ultimately rush duel on, and Goha stopped producing the parts and basically struck a deal with her and said, if you take down rush duels, we'll start producing your parts and your family's parts again so that your machines will not go extinct. And Asana was in a very tough position because she genuinely enjoyed rush dueling. She liked Yuga as a person a lot, but her family's legacy and the legacy of everything that she has worked on ultimately was more important, and that's what drove her to go after Yuga and to attack him and his friends. And keep in mind, she also defeated Yuga in a duel. Yuga has lost 4 duels up until this point, Rook, Nail, Asana, and Roman, but the fact that half of his losses are from girl characters, and remember, this is the main protagonist we are talking about, that is insane. That is something I never thought we would see in any sort of Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime. I want to remind you guys that this has only happened twice prior to Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s, and it's already happened 2 times in the first 40 episodes of Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s. It happened when Yugi surrendered to Rebecca, and it happened when Yuya forgot how to pendulum summon in a duel against Yuzu. So the only 2 times that a girl duelist beat a main protagonist in the past 20 years of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime, Duel Monsters all the way to Vrains, both times, it wasn't really legit. Wait, think about that. So Asana, very in...
What is he saying is happened in, like, the first time?
The Machine Cavalry Club, which is what her family's invention was, creating these machines where you could duel and ultimately rush duel on, and Goha stopped producing the parts, and basically struck a deal with her and said, if you take down rush duels, we'll start producing your parts and your family's parts again so that your machines will not go extinct. And Asana was in a very tough position because she genuinely enjoyed rush dueling. She liked Yuga as a person a lot, but her family's legacy and the legacy of everything that she has worked on ultimately was more important, and that's what drove her to go after Yuga and to attack him and his friends. And keep in mind, she also defeated Yuga in a duel. Yuga has lost 4 duels up until this point, Rook, Nail, Asana, and Roman, but the fact that half of his losses are from girl characters, and remember, this is the main protagonist we are talking about, that is insane. That is something I never thought we would see in any sort of Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime. I want to remind you guys that this has only happened twice prior to Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s, and it's already happened 2 times in the first 40 episodes of Yu-Gi-Oh! 7s. It happened when Yugi surrendered to Rebecca, and it happened when Yuya forgot how to pendulum summon in a duel against Yuzu. So the only 2 times that a girl duelist beat a main protagonist in the past 20 years of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime, Duel Monsters all the way to Vrains, both times...
That's her boss monster? Looks like a... What's that archetype? It looks like an infinite track. Yo, it looks like an infinite track.
20 years of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime, Duel Monsters all the way to Vrains, both times, it wasn't really legit. Think about that. So Asana, very in-depth, very interesting character. Then we have Tiger, who I absolutely love. Tiger is Rook's older sister and is also billed as a very good duelist. You notice a trend here, right? All these girls have their comeuppance, not only with their interesting character backgrounds and backstories, but they all have actually good dueling ability, and they actually win duels. And for the first time in a long time, it feels like these characters are not just here because...
The hell's going on here?
Oh, the show needs to have some girls. It feels like these characters are actually here because they actually contribute to the story. And it's the first Yu-Gi-Oh! In a while where I feel like that is the case. And they're not just damsels in distress. I have not gotten the damsels in distress vibe from any single one of these girls. And in past Yu-Gi-Ohs, there's pretty much always been a time where I felt like the main girl lead was a damsel in distress at one point or another. So that's also something that Yu-Gi-Oh! Sevens has done really, really well. But Tiger's personality is an absolute joy to watch. She is such a hothead, but she is literally billed as someone who is great at everything she does. We got some good background story on her, and she is the only character in this universe that has been able to defeat her younger brother, Rook. It was in a flashback, but at the moment, Rook is undefeated. She is the only character that actually...
Who the hell is Rook? Yu-Gi-Oh! Sevens Rook. Rook X Rook. Oh, this guy. The blue-haired one. That's his name? His name is Rook. The friend... He's undefeated? Oh, dude. They're going to make him lose in the last episode to Yuga, aren't they? Hey, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to lie. The kids kind of got some swag, chat. I'm not going to lie. This is... The kids kind of got some swag. I kind of like this kid now, chat. Kind of feeling like this could be, maybe I should change this to my avatar when I start uploading again on YouTube. I might cut this and change this to my avatar. What episode? This is from episode 2. Got that. All right. I just need to remember that. Okay, so they both have blue hair. That's the relation.
Strikes fear into Rook on a consistent basis and has Rook's number when it comes to dueling. Tiger also has a win on this show. Another girl character that has a win is Tsuchiko. Tsuchiko has only dueled once, but she took down Roman, which is a very impressive win considering Roman has already defeated the main protagonist and...
So, is her whole, like, stick sushi? Because it's in her name and she's holding sushi. So, I don't know. That doesn't seem that deep. Tsuchiko. Does she play Tsuchips, chat?
Gakuto, probably the third most relevant guy character in the entire show. Tsuchiko played a massive role, low-key, in inspiring Roman to be better. Her deck completely countered Roman's deck. The stakes were, of course, very low. They were fighting over a TV remote and what channel and what show they wanted to watch. But this duel was the turning point for Roman's character in getting rid of Berserk Mode. She went into Berserk Mode, wasn't able to finish the duel when she was in Berserk Mode, left Berserk Mode, and that's when Tsuchiko was able to defeat her.
So
Tsuchiko, another girl character that has a win. And finally, five girl characters have wins in this show already. The last one is Finger Chikako. We have aliens that are similar to her. Sirako, Kakako, which Kakako was just introduced to us. I don't know what role these aliens play, but I have a feeling that they could be tied to whatever the main Kakako. Villain threat of this entire story is. We know they're deeply tied.
Okay, we don't need to know about... Wait. I want to hear about the 37-year-old mom.
That have not gotten wins yet. I just mentioned Sirako, but more importantly, I want to focus on Mimi Itachi and Ron.
Damn, chat, there, you know, it's a lot of girls on this show.
Honest, but it counts nonetheless. And even girl characters that have not gotten wins yet.
Dude, there's a lot Are they actually trying to, like, redefine the place for women, chat, in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime? Because there's a lot of females in this show. Like, Yu-Gi-Oh! Art V had a lot of girl characters just by the fact that, like, the main protagonist and the main girl all had four different versions. So, like, I don't even know if that counts. You know what I mean? They both inherently have the, like... I don't know. When you think of Yu-Gi-Oh! DM, it's just pretty much Taya and Mai, right, chat? For a majority of the show. I mean, you have a Shizu... For, like, Battle City, but it's just pretty much two girls, you know? Maybe throwing a Rebecca here and there, but not a lot. Like, this seems a lot. Seems like a lot of girls. Put it in Waifu Part 2.
But more importantly, I want to focus on Mimi Itachi and Ranze. Both of these characters, Mimi and Ranze.
That forehead, though. Jesus. Ash Blossom cosplay gone wrong, chat. Like, I mean, I'm just... She not have a mirror? Like,
Anze have
She plays press one if she plays Ash Blossom beatdown, chat. No idea how you win with Ash Blossom beatdown, but like
complex issues, and even though they've both dueled multiple times and have not gotten wins yet, Mimi is currently the president of Goha Corporation. We got great backstory on Mimi, even though she looks young. She's a 36-year-old mother to Yoshio, who she actually had to duel at one point, and has climbed up the corporate ladder at Goha, working her ass off her entire life, and her dream was always to get to the top. She sees the former president Goha drop dead in front of her, and learns that Mr. Goha is actually a drone. The drone needs a new host since the old one died, and Mimi decides to take the drone up on that offer. So Goha's plans are to stop Rush Duels. Mimi likes Yuga and his crew and loves Rush Duels. Her son loves Rush Duels as well. So Mimi right now is in a very...
Man, I felt like that would have actually been a pretty powerful plot twist if I didn't know it was coming and it didn't get spoiled. Wow, thanks, Dylan. He was actually starting to make me think, wow, are you telling me the plot in this show might actually be somewhat complex? Because real talk, chat, I think I would watch this show and just skip all the duels. I'm not interested in the duels at all. I just want to watch the show strictly for the plot. Like, I'm not interested in Rush Duels. Maybe a couple of the maximum summons, but like, the plot seems, I don't know, it seems much more mature than... Like, when I look at this show, I just see a show with a bunch of 10-year-olds. And I'm just like, I as a 30-year-old man, I can't watch this shit, right?
Very difficult position. She's not fully brainwashed. In fact, she hasn't even really shown any signs of brainwashing. But the complexity there with what Mimi's character is going to have to do in the future to destroy Rush Duels or to go against her entire company's motivation, including the helmet that is currently on her head, probably capable of eliminating her if necessary, is going to be very fascinating to see. And then Ronze has these complex issues.
Okay, I'm not interested in this character. Wait, this video is from 9 months ago. So the show is way further beyond this, right, chat? The show could be, I don't know, like 20 or at least 15 episodes ahead of this. Okay. Yeah, I'm not interested in that character. That was like, that was pretty interesting, chat. Fighting for control is mature. I mean, something adults have to do, you know? How does this make you feel as a Gen 1 Pokemon fan? 3 arcs later. Waifu Part 2, 7 treats females better. Well, so, I never want to, what's it called, chat? I never want to make a video that, like, comes off as woke, right? That's why I even put the little woke warning, chat, in my own, what's it called? Like, I even put the woke warning in that video. Like, I'm not trying to make a political statement. I'm trying to, exactly, you go woke, go broke. Just trying to make an entertaining video. So I feel like the title of that just sounds woke, Dark Emperor. Like, I'll do another waifu style video, but it's probably just gonna be about gay Atticus. Yo, that video still has potential. It'll probably just be about Dark Magician Girl.